desperate to be in love again. It's okay if people mistake you for insane. Insanity is better than profanity, is better than posterity, is better than being aware of it. I'm so close to fucking a ghost, cause you only exist inside my head. I'm full of existential dread. Should be writing happy songs instead of staring into the abyss, wondering if I've been missed by people who say they love me. Now they say I'm barely worthy of their time. I've been living with myself for a while now, and I'd say roommates is a better term for what our friends are supposed to be. I don't settle for neutrality on a day-to-day basis. I don't say shit, but on Fridays I tend to blow up on Twitter about all the people who are making me bitter, the ones who all left before winter. When you're desperate to be in love again, it's okay if people say you're sad, cause who fucking gives a jockstrap if they critique anything but your soul cap? I'm aligning my chakras, trying not to stalk you on Tumblr or Facebook or any other social media platform. You could recreate yourself in my image, maybe think they could be different. I wouldn't go on about my past, and maybe for once I can make you laugh. I don't mean to sound like a lunatic, but you're really pulling on my dick. Even though I've sworn off the worst to myself, I'd gladly make an exception. Regretting my decisions with wise men not telling me I'm sinning, just cause I'm reaching out for something that isn't even there. Instigator, replicator, making them so overrated. Debunk the thoughts of self and see your pain. This relationship is religious oligarchy, cause you think you're God and you're controlling me. That's okay, cause I think your ghost is holy in my book. When you're desperate to be in love again, it's okay if people mistake you for insane, cause insanity is better than profanity, is better than posterity, is better than being aware of me.